Good evening, everyone. Am I audible to you? Yes. Let's see. I hope we have to start nervous tissue in today's class. Nerve or neuron, you can say. We have leftover there only. Tell me. Yes, we start a little bit. Let's see. We were there with sodium potassium, you can say system. Resting membrane potential were done. Very good. Let's see what we need to discuss. Actually, see, we have done with resting membrane potential because inside was negative and outside was positive. Let's see. We have done till here. Everyone. Yes. Now what happened? A threshold stimulus has arrived. Threshold stimulus has arrived. And what's that? What is threshold stimulus? It is the minimum potential that is required for conduction of impulse. Agreed? Try to understand my point. If you have to open up a door, okay, you are going to require some minimum force for that. Yes or no? If you have to open up a door, you are going to require some minimum force for that. Agreed, everyone? Yes or no? That will be known as threshold thing. Can you be able, you can say you be able to open the door when you are applying a force less than threshold? Can you open? No. Likewise, sub-threshold potential cannot be conducted. Getting my point? It will not be conducted. What happens? Threshold potential has arrived. That led to opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. Arrival of threshold potential has led to opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. Yes or no? Sodium is more outside. In the previous diagram, you must have seen. Sodium is more outside and less inside, around 10 times more outside. Yes or no? Everyone? Sodium is around 10 times more outside. Agreed, everyone? Yes. So what will happen over here? Influx of sodium will take place. What? Influx of sodium. Influx means moving into the cell. Moving into the cell. That has taken place. Now what will happen? Try to understand. This is voltage-gated channel. Near to this, it will become positive. Near to this, it will become positive, and outside, it will remain negative. It will be negative. Yes or no? If you are removing positive charge from here, what will be the potential over here? If you are removing positive, negative. Yes, Shraddha is saying negative. Anybody else? Yes, everyone. Let's see. So, because of movement of sodium ion from here, just outside membrane, it will be negative, and here it will be positive. Yes or no? Only, it happens only locally. At the local level, means near to sodium potassium, sodium voltage gated sodium channel only. Away from this, it will remain negative inside and it will remain positive outside. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Because of influx of sodium ion, the inside becomes positive and outside becomes negative. Where? In the area in vicinity of sodium channel. Away from sodium channel, inside will remain negative and outside will remain positive. Everyone agreed to this? Agreed to this? Yes, everyone. Let's see. Do you people know current is being conducted from positive to negative direction? It will be conducted in this way. And I have taken only one sodium channel into consideration. This current will act as threshold potential for another sodium channel. And it will be conducted like this all along the membrane. Agreed, everyone? Yes. Let's see. Now what happens? Do you know? This membrane is inside it is negative and outside it is positive. Which kind of membrane is this? This membrane is known as polarized membrane. Polarized membrane, yes or no? It is having two poles. You can say inside and outside. Outside is positive and inside is negative. This kind of membrane is known as, you can say, polarized membrane. Now you see, here it became positive inside. Can you think from negative to positive? Zero will be there in between. If something is becoming positive from negative, yes, everyone. So when potential difference is zero, that means inside as well as outside, the potential is equal. Everyone, the potential is equal. In that case, will this polarized state will be there or not? That state when inside and outside is going to be equal, that state is going to be known as depolarized state. Yes or no? What is the reason? Yes, Adit is saying yes. So let's see. From polarized state, it is becoming depolarized. Can I call this process as depolarization? Tell me, dear. Yes. And what is the reason behind depolarization? Is it influx of sodium ion? Yes. Everyone. Do you people have any doubt? Just give me a minute. Yes, everyone. Tell me. Influx of sodium ion is responsible for depolarization. Now let's see. Opening of sodium channel is short-lived, means it got closed. Now sodium got trapped inside it, inside the exoplasm of exon. Yes or no? Due to closure of this sodium channel, what had happened? Sodium got trapped inside. Now, will this sodium repel K plus? Yes, it is going to repel it. And now, this voltage-gated K plus channel will open. K plus has started moving out. That will lead to efflux of K plus ion. So what will happen? This place, from here, you are removing a positive charge. That is K plus. This will become negative again. This will become negative again. You see, all negative inside and all positive outside, that state is achieved over here again. So from depolarized state, it is again becoming polarized. Yes or no? It is again becoming polarized. That process will be known as repolarization. Agreed? Everyone? Tell me, dear. That will be known as repolarization. And what is the ion and which kind of movement which is responsible for repolarization? Tell me, dear. Tell me. What is responsible for repolarization? K plus efflux. Great. Let's see, everyone. Here, opening of voltage gated K plus channel is there, repolarization. Now, what is the difference between this state and this resting state? Tell me that. Here, K plus is more outside, slightly more outside, and Na plus is slightly less inside. Sorry, more inside, less outside. K plus is slightly more outside and Na plus is slightly more inside. Agreed? Everyone? Yes. So how it is going to reach this state? Now the sodium potassium pump will act. It will take 3 Na plus outside and it will take 2 K plus inside. Everyone, do you have any problem in this? This is all about nerve conduction. Please do read 11th NCERT biology. Okay, it is explained over here. That much is sufficient, everyone. Pump is going to work by using ATP. Try to understand my point. This is the pump. It is having three binding sites for Na plus, three, and two binding sites for K plus. Okay, when the ATP will be used, this two K plus will be pushed in, and these three Na plus will be pushed out. Yes or no, everyone? It is a means of active transport. Pranav, are you clear with this? Yes, everyone. If you people have any doubt in this, you can ask. Now, see, here conduction is taking place. At that time, I have put an electrode inside and one electrode at the surface. And that will be known as what? Potential inside minus potential outside when? At the time of conduction, action potential. So, do you people have any problem with resting membrane potential, threshold potential and axial potential? Tell me that. Is it all right now? Please should see to it for a minute. Done with this? Yes. Aditya, resting means when it will remain potential inside minus potential outside. Let's see. This is also potential inside minus potential outside. And this is also potential inside minus potential outside, but into two different situations. This is at the resting state when no conduction is taking place. And this is at the time when conduction is taking place. Yes or no? Always you are going to measure the potential difference between inside of the membrane and outside of it. Everyone, any doubt in this? Aditya, are you clear? Yes. Let's see. Now we will be talking about your nervous system. Few things we will be discussing regarding that. Just give me a minute. Let's see, everyone. What is your brain? Have we discussed brain in the previous class? Yes. Pranav, are you done? Or you need to see previous slide? You are done? Let's see. Everyone, now done? Yes. Let's see. We are going to see. Are we done with brain? Yes. So the brain. Your brain is going to have following parts, and the parts are forebrain, midbrain, and hind brain. Agreed, everyone? Forebrain is going to have cerebral hemisphere and diencephalon. Midbrain, let's see, in this posterior part, here, I have taken a diagram while watching from this side. Can you people see these four round swellings? Can you people see them? Yes, they are known as corpora, quadrigemina. The quad word is used for four round swelling. Okay. And your hind brain is going to have pons, medulla, and cerebellum. Is it like that? Everyone? Yes. Now you see, this is your midbrain. This is your pons and this is your medulla. Can you see them? They are there in a continuity. They are there in a continuity? Yes. They are known as brainstem.
They are known as brain stem. What all structures that are included in them? What are all structures are there which are included in them? They are midbrain plus pons plus medulla. Agreed, everyone? Agreed, everyone? Now, I will be talking about cerebrum. See, there are two cerebral hemispheres. Okay, right, rather I will be writing over here cerebrum. Agreed, everyone? Two cerebral hemisphere. Let's see. I have cut it from the middle and half part is taken away. Now you will be able to see only the half part. Can you see this structure? Can you see this structure? Let me take one more diagram. Otherwise, you people will get confused. Just give me a minute. I am taking one more. Let's see. I will be discussing this thing in a bit detail now. Before that, I have to take one more diagram for brain. Can you see this diagram? Yes. Let's see. Everyone. Can you see this diagram? I am cutting it from here into two halves and watching it from the lateral side. Agreed, everyone? Tell me. Yes. That is known as sagittal section. Now see, can you see this structure which is distinct? Do you know what is this? This is corpus callosum. What? What do you think? What is the function of corpus callosum? It connects to cerebral hemisphere. Everyone agrees to this? Yes. Let's see. I am talking about this area. Okay, let's see. This area is like this. Like this. See, this is a depression known as central sulcus. In front of this, this is known as primary motor area. This area is known as primary sensory area. Agreed? Everyone, what is the function of primary motor area? General motor, like motor, general motor activity starts from here. You are walking or doing anything else, that will be starting from primary motor area. Responsible for general sensation. Okay. This sulcus is known as lateral sulcus. And here is one more sulcus. This is known as parieto occipital sulcus. Sulcus means depression. Agreed? You can see over here. This is there. This is sulcus. And this elevation is known as gyrus. Yes or no? Everyone? Agreed, everyone? Do you people know about sulcus and gyrus? Yes, Ritu is saying yes. Tell me, dear, what is the function of sulcus and gyrus? What is its significance? Yes, I will show that to you. I am saying, what is the role of sulcus and gyrus? Yes, it is helping in accommodation of more neurons in less space. Yes or no? Agreed? The more is the sulcus and gyrus, the more intelligent person is going to be. The more is the number of sulcus and gyrus, the more intelligent the person is going to be. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes, of course. Now, these things are going to, divide the cerebral hemisphere into frontal lobe. What? Frontal lobe. This is temporal lobe. This is occipital lobe. And this one is parietal lobe. What? What I have told, general sensory area or primary sensory area, there are few spatial senses also. This blue color thing, can you see? This is your visual area. What? This is your visual area. Getting my point? Somebody will ask you, visual area is present in which lobe? What will you say? What will you say? Occipital lobe. Yes. They are spatial senses. Here is the Broca's area for a speech. Here is the olfactory area. They all are the, like olfaction is also a spatial sense. Everyone. So this is the function of cerebral hemisphere. Now I will talk about diencephalon.
Sir?
Yes.
So could you show the diagram again, please?
This one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you can see. Everyone. Are you done?
Just a minute, sir.
No issues.
Done, sir.
Yes. Now, we will talk about diencephalon. Please see to it. There are three parts that is going to be there with diencephalon. One is epithalamus. Second is thalamus. One is hypothalamus. Okay. you people can interact a bit. You just imagine your room. You just imagine your room. What all are there? There is floor, there is roof, and there is wall. Yes or no? Walls. I am going to give you an analogy. Getting my point? Actually, there is one space. See, can you see this empty space? This is going to be your third ventricle. What? Third ventricle. Okay, there are chambers which is present inside the brain also. Third ventricles. Third ventricle is like a room. Its roof is going to be known as epithalamus. Hypo means on the lower side. Its floor is going to be known as hypothalamus. And its wall is going to be thalamus. Now tell me, what happens inside your room? If you have to take wires for electricity connection, you take that. Yes, I'm going to repeat, Shraddha. Inside, just imagine a condition when you are taking or you are making electricity connection inside your room. What do you do? Wires are going to pass through the walls or in the center of the room. Through walls, na? Similar is the function of thalamus. Anything going up or down, that will go through the walls. Hence, thalamus act as relay center. I have told you people regarding hypothalamus in detail. Agreed? We have discussed hypothalamus in detail. Everyone? We have done that? Now, epithalamus having one structure is habenula. Another is pineal body. One structure is habenula. Another is pineal body. Have you heard about pineal body? It is going to secrete a hormone, melatonin. And habenula is like a stalk. Everyone, any doubt in this? Tell me, dear. Pineal body, I have taught you people, na? Melatonin is there, diurnal rhythm and all. Say yes or no. What is a stalk in the sense? A stalk is a small cord like structure. This one, like a stalk of hypothalamus, is known as infundibulum. Earlier we have discussed that. Yes or no? A stalk means it is not a stalk, it is a stalk. S-T-A-L-K. It is like a connecting cord-like thing. Agreed? Adit, got it? Yes. Good. Pranav, you can make me host. Due to some reason, I think I have lost connection. Am I audible, Pranav? Is it showing now?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, let's see. Let's see over here. Are you done with midbrain?
No.
Yes, tell me.
So, because you logged out of the meeting, we're not able to send messages to you, sir.
After that, you people are not able to send me the message.
Yes, sir.
Few of you are able to do that. Now are you able to do that? Can you send me message now?
No, sir.
You can leave and rejoin.
So could you just send a message to everyone so that maybe then we can message you back?
Let's try. I have sent the message.
No, sir, it didn't work.
Sir, can you enable us to chat with each other and then we can click on your name and chat again and then you can put to privately again?
No, sir, if you just click on the one that you just sent only, it'll work.
What are you saying?
So the message that you sent, I clicked on your name in that, so I can send messages now.
Now, can you see that? You guys sent that? Are you able to do that now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, let's see. Everyone? Yes, now everyone can send. You can mute yourself. You can mute yourself. Yes, everyone, let's see. Let's see here. Okay. Icons are slightly different in this device. That is why I'm not able to do that. Let's see. Are you done with midbrain? Any doubt in this? Yes. Let's see. I will be discussing hindbrain now. Hindbrain. It is having three parts. and they are pons medulla and another is cerebellum. Getting my point? Cerebellum is popularly known as a small brain. Yes or no? It is the second largest part of human brain. Second largest part of human brain. Do you know what is this responsible for? What is the responsibility of cerebellum in your body? Have you seen a person? See, I am going to ask you a question. Have you seen a drunk person? Yes. What do you think? I am going to give you two conditions. One person is there whose cerebellum is not acting properly. And another person is there whose primary motor area present in the cerebral hemisphere is not working. What is the difference between them? What is the difference between them? See, if somebody will be having problem in the motor area, that person will become a paralyzed person. Means muscle will not work. But if cerebellum will be affected, in that case, the pattern of walking is going to change. Yes or no? That is known as gait. G-A-I-T. Gait. Pattern of walking. In the medical language, that is known as gait. Responsible for gait. It is pattern of walking. Everyone, tell me, dear. It is gait that is pattern of walking. Any doubt in this? Now, medulla. Having many centers, like it is having respiratory rhythm center, respiratory rhythm center. Agreed? Tell me, dear. Yes, alcohol is going to affect cerebellum only. Alcohol will slow down cerebellum only. Yes or no? So, respiratory rhythm center is there. Vomit center or emetic center. Vomiting is there, no? That is being controlled from here only. It is having cardiovascular center. Means the center which is controlling the heart. Respiratory rhythm center is responsible for your respiration, normal breathing. Okay, pons having pneumotaxis center. And pons having pneumotaxis center and apneustic center. Just name is going to suffice. You people write down. I am going to join you back in 2 minutes. Just in 2 minutes. Please write. Yes, everyone. Done with that? Pranav is saying, how does alcohol slow down cerebellum? Actually, alcohol is having, getting my point. Alcohol is going to be absorbed from the stomach, and alcohol having, you can say, property, it will slow down the conduction. It will slow down the conduction. Any alcohol or any drug, you can say many drugs that are used in mental illness, that is going to slow down the brain. So that overthinking should be avoided. Getting my point? Conduction will be slowed down by alcohol. Getting my point? Everyone? I have told second largest part of human brain. Which is the largest part? Largest part is cerebrum. Everyone, do you people want to ask anything about brain now? Anybody having doubt regarding brain? Tell me here. Now, we will be talking about a spinal cord. We will be talking about a spinal cord. A spinal cord, let's see. I think screen sharing has stopped, no? Let's see, dear. We will be starting with a spinal cord. Let's see. A spinal cord, let's see. First thing that you people should be knowing, this is your brain. Medulla oblongata, and only that is going to continue as a spinal cord. Okay? Just a minute, dear. Naam, 1 minute malik de denge. Just give me a minute. Arre na, hum jab naam batane ke to kehta hai ki jo naam ka zarurat nahi hai. Yasika, Shreya, or Anjal Gupta. Shreya, Anjal Gupta. Jimal. Hum aapko photo bhej dete hain. Yes, let's see important thing that is there, the spinal cord. First thing that you people should be knowing, this is your brain, this is medulla oblongata. Somebody has asked me,
sir, what is the function of apneustic center and pneumotaxic center? See, Aditya, pneumotaxic center is going to see when you are running. Getting my point, na? Pneumotaxic center will decrease your time of inspiration, and hence the time of expiration, means duration of your breathing will decrease and number will increase. Getting my point, Aditya? These are the part of mechanism of regulation of breathing. Aditya, are you getting it? Yes. And apneustic center, what is apneusis? Do you people know what is apneusis? If you have asked, you should learn. What is apneusis? It is arresting of breathing in inspiratory stage. Which stage? The apneustic center having ability to increase the depth of your, no, abnormal pattern cannot be there. Apneustic center is going to increase your duration of inspiration. Deep inspiration will be there. Yes or no? Everyone? Agree with me? Agree with me? Yes. Aditya is saying yes. Then a spinal cord. First thing that is there, this is your brain. Brain is situated inside cranium. Everyone agreed to this? Brain is situated inside cranium. Agreed? Now, there is a opening present inside the cranium. This is known as foramen magnum. What? Magnum. It is magnum. Through that only, a spinal cord comes out. Everyone? Agreed? So brain and spinal cords are connected. A spinal cord is connected, you can say, is protected by a bony structure known as vertebral column. Is known as vertebral column. Agreed, everyone? Everyone, do you people have any doubt in this? It is protected by bony structure known as vertebral column. This is a spinal cord. Now, one thing that I want to tell you all, I am going to make a cross section of this. This will be like this. Your spinal cord is going to be like this. Let me take gray color over here. Yes or no? This is made up of gray matter. And this is known as, this is also gray matter only. And this one is white matter. First thing. Have I told you reason behind being gray matter and white matter? Have I told you? Why it is gray matter? Why it is gray matter? Tell me, dear.
neuron cell body is gray in color, and myelin sheath is white in color. So wherever myelinated neuron is there, that will be white in color. Yes or no? Yes. That is showing myelin sheath. Agreed, everyone? Now, see, this is known as dorsal horn. This is known as ventral horn, which is gray matter. Now you see. From that is going to arise dorsal root. This structure is there on both the sides. I am making it on only one side over here, but it is on both the sides. This is known as ventral horn. What? Ventral root is originating from ventral horn. Have I told you people bipolar and pseudo unipolar neuron? Bipolar neuron and pseudo unipolar, that kind of thing. Have I taught you people? Yes. Shraddha, let's say, where have I told you people that pseudo unipolar neuron thing? I must have told you it is there in the dorsal root of a spinal cord. It is there in this only. Let's see. What is going to happen? Let's see. Important thing is there to be understood. Let's see. Actually, this is known as, this swelling is known as dorsal root ganglion. Now you see, everyone, pay attention to this. I will be saying over here, one neuron is entering. One neuron is entering. See, this is your receptor. What is the definition of receptor that I have told you people? What are they? What is the definition of receptor? Tell me, dear. What are they? Only sense stimuli. I told you they are transducers. They change one form of energy into another form of energy. Have I told you people? So see over here, receptor, from receptor, this fiber is going towards the central nervous system. So this will be known as afferent or sensory fiber. This is the pseudo unipolar neuron. It will come over here. Let's see. From here only, many neuron terminals are there, axon terminals are there, rather. It is forming a synapse over here and moving out to a effector organ. In other pathway, there can be one more neuron . This is known as interneuron. I'm going to label all of them. E factor 2. Try to understand my point. This is your forehand for say, forehand, this is your fingers. This is your arm. You have touched something that is noxious. Heat or something. You will try to take your hand in this direction. Na? Will you do that? You will try to take your hand in this direction? Yes. So, two muscles are going to act. One muscle is this. This muscle, which will contract. And one muscle is this one, which is going to relax. Agreed, everyone. And what these sudden movement to any noxious stimulus is known as? Is known as what? Reflex action. Everyone. And what is this path known as? This path? Reflex arc. Gayatri is saying reflex arc. Tell me, dear, what all are there in the reflex arc? What all are there in reflex arc? First is receptor. Second is afferent or sensory fiber. Third is interneuron. Let's see. This one is interneuron. Fourth one is, these fibers are known as efferent fibers. Fourth one is efferent fibers. Fifth one is known as effector. They are also known as motor fibers. Agreed, everyone? Tell me, dear. Everyone, do you have any doubt in this? Let's see. One thing I want to ask you. See, this one is also a reflex arc. And this one is also a reflex arc. What do you think? Out of these five, which can be there and which cannot be there? Tell me, dear. Which can be there? Interneuron is not necessary. It can be there and it cannot be there. On this basis, reflex arc is of two types. Reflex arc is of two types. One is monosynaptic. Another is polysynaptic. I will search for examples and you can discuss me. You can send me messages. Getting my point? The thing is, see dear, whatever time we have, I'm trying to help you people in the best way. If you have any doubt, you can send to Gaurav sir, he will send me, or you can send me directly. Getting my point? So you search for them. Now one is conditioned reflex, and another is unconditioned reflex, or simple.
Sir?
Tell me, dear.
Sir, out of monosynaptic and polysynaptic, which one has the interneuron?
Let's see. Polysynaptic means more than one synapse. See over here. This is polysynaptic, na? So polysynaptic pathway is going to have interneurons. Yes or no? Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Good question. Let's see. Conditioned reflex, and one is non-conditioned or simple reflex. A scientist was there named Pavlov. Do you know what they have done? Dog was there. He used to feed the dog. Before that, he is going to ring a bell in the temple. Getting my point? Bell in the temple. He used to do that daily. One day he has seen that he is not giving the food. Just after hearing the bell, dog starts salivating. So that means dog knows this thing, that after this bell, food is going to be there. For this, previous experience is required. And for this, no previous experience is required. Everyone, do you have any doubt in this? Tell me. Agreed? Like, if you are going to touch anything that is hot. Yes, Sada, you're right. The thing that is there, what have I told? What have I told you? What are we discussing? Conditioned and non-conditioned reflex. Yes, I was giving the example of non-conditioned reflex. If you are going to touch anything that is too hot, irrespective of previous experience is there or not, you are going to be hurt and you will suddenly take out your hand from there. Yes or no? Agreed? And if some food is there that you have not seen earlier, you are not going to pay attention to that. Agreed, everyone? So this is there. Anything that you people want to ask? Now, one important thing. Now you see. All these fibers, the sensory fiber, the motor fiber, and everything is going to make a spinal nerve over here. So, a spinal nerve is sensory, motor, or mixed in nature. Tell me, dear. A spinal cord is, all spinal cords are, how many pairs are there? First thing is 31 pair of spinal nerve is there and mixed in nature. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. Are you people following any book? Yes, I'm going to give you NCERT. Please follow. Let's see. ganglion. What is ganglion? There are two words, ganglion and nucleus. There are two words that are there. One is ganglion and one is nucleus. They all are small processing units present. Ganglion is collection of cell bodies outside, collection of cell bodies outside CNS. A nucleus is also collection of cell bodies in nucleus, sorry, in CNS. They are nothing but a smaller processing, local processing unit present inside your nervous system. They are nothing but collection of cell bodies only. Everyone, please tell me. Clear? Yes, dear. Now, one more thing that is there is synapse. One more thing that is there is synapse. It is junction of two neurons. What happens? We have seen this thing now. See, this synaptic knob, what they are going to contain? This synaptic knobs are going to contain what? What they are going to contain, synaptic knob? I am going to make that only. See over here, dear. This is synaptic knob, known as presynaptic membrane. Now, dendrite of another neuron. This is known as post synaptic membrane, and there is a space that is going to be present between them, and that space is going to be known as synaptic cleft. What? Together they will be known as synapse. This is going to contain synaptic vesicles, which are going to contain neurotransmitters. They are synaptic vesicles. They are having neurotransmitter in them. Let's see, they are the neurotransmitter. What? They are neurotransmitter. Agreed, everyone? Yes. Adit is saying right thing. Let's see over here. What will happen? This is going to have they are the receptors. So receptors for neurotransmitter. Let's see what will happen. First, this vesicle is going to move towards this membrane. It will fuse with the membrane. Going to release the
neurotransmitter over here. This neurotransmitter will bind to receptor, and here conduction will start. Agreed? So if somebody will ask you, receptor for neurotransmitter is present on which membrane, what will you say? Presynaptic or postsynaptic? Tell me, dear. Presynaptic or yes, agreed. There are certain more mechanism, but not required. Okay, if you have read and you want to ask, this kind of synapse is known as chemical synapse. Which kind of which synapse? Chemical synapse. Let's see. They are known as chemical synapse. Other types of synapse are also there. Electrical synapse, but that is rare. So not required. Impulse will come. Vesicle will move towards the membrane. Which membrane? Presynaptic membrane. It will fuse with that. Agreed? Everyone. Do you people have any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Please let me know. No. Let's see. One is reproduction. Next topic is reproduction. What do you think? What is reproduction? What is reproduction, dear? Let's see. So reproduction is a biological process. A biological process by which an organism produces offspring like it in order to continue its own race. Yes or no? Everyone. Let's see, dear. Let's see. Reproduction is of two types. One is asexual reproduction. Another is sexual reproduction. One is asexual reproduction, another is sexual reproduction. Let's see, dear. What is the difference between them? First, it is with or without gamete. Formation. It is with gamete formation only. Mind it, with or without, I am saying gametes can be formed in asexual reproduction also. Here, fertilization. Do you know what is fertilization?
What is fertilization, dear? It is fusion of male and female gamete. Yes. Great. Here, fertilization is present. After fertilization, a unicellular structure is formed that is known as zygote. If fertilization is not there, zygote will also be not there. Zygote is formed. Zygote is not formed and zygote is formed. Dhyan dena. Here, the offspring will be similar to parent. Here, offspring will not be similar to parent. Everyone, they are different from both the parent. They can be uniparental, they can be biparental. It is uniparental always. Single parent is involved. It is uniparental or biparental. Usually biparental. Everyone agrees to these things. Anybody having doubt in this? Sexual reproduction is more advanced and provide a scope for variation. And provide a scope for variation. Everyone? Yes, you are right. Asexual as well as sexual mode of reproduction. No issues at all? Are you people getting it? Now, I will say means of asexual reproduction. Means of asexual reproduction or methods of Can you people tell me few of the methods? First is fission. Second is fission can be binary fission, can be multiple fission. Getting my point? Then fission is there. Budding is there. Like in Hydra. Fragmentation is there. It is there in sponges. Getting my point? Regeneration can be there. It is there in plain area. Regeneration is never a true method of reproduction. It is not there. Tell me. Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Clear?
Now, I will be talking about sexual reproduction. And one more thing I will like to clarify over here, one definition. Because in asexual reproduction, as offspring is almost similar to the parent, they can be called as clone. What is clone? It is morphologically and genetically similar individual. They are known as clone. Everyone agrees to this? Getting my point? Everyone. All of you are preparing for which competitive exam, IIT or medical? What is your goal in, you can say, next coming year? That I want to ask. No, this exam I know. Actually, I am taking KVPI class only. Yes. I just want to ask in which stream you are. Yes. Yes. This class is KVPI, that I know. Pranav is saying most of you are from the, you can say, JE side only. I think Shraddha is saying NEET, else everyone IIT. Others? No issues. Let's see. I have just asked for the sake of information only. Are you people done with this? Now I will talk about sexual reproduction. Let's see. Sexual reproduction. Let's see, dear. Yes, tell me. Anything you want to ask? Yes. Let's see. What I want to tell you all, sexual reproduction events. What all the key event in sexual reproduction is fertilization. Fertilization. It is the union of two gametes. Two gametes means male and female gamete. Male and female gamete to form zygote. Fertilization having events that is taking place before fertilization is known as pre-fertilization event, and events that is going to take place after fertilization is known as post-fertilization event. Tell me, dear, any doubt in that? No? Pre-fertilization event and post-fertilization event, what all are there? First is gametogenesis. It is formation of gametes. Agreed?
gametogenesis having two events as far as human reproduction is concerned, spermatogenesis. And another is oogenesis. As the name suggests, spermatogenesis is the formation of a sperm. Yes or no, everyone? Everyone? And oogenesis is formation of ovum. Second thing is gamete transfer. Gamete, male and female gamete will be transferred, any of that. That is known as pollination in case of plant, and copulation in case of human. And once gamete transfer will take place, then the next event is fertilization. Once fertilization is going to take place, following events are going to take place. One is embryogenesis. It is formation of embryo. Formation of embryo. What all are there? Have you heard about morula? Then blastula or blastocyst? Then gastrula? Do you people know about these names? See over here. Once this embryo will be formed, this embryo is going to be embedded inside the uterus. That is known as implantation. What? Tell me, dear. That is known as implantation. What? What is this process? It is the process of embryo into uterus. Everyone agrees to this? Aditya? Morula, they are the stages of embryo. I have told you people for the sake of, you can say, just listening to these things. Not detail is not required. Morula is a solid ball-like structure that is formed at the earliest stage. Okay? Solid ball-like structure. Now, embryogenesis, implantation, and then after implantation, organogenesis. It is the formation of organ. Then comes parturition. What do you people know about parturition? Tell me, dear. It is the process of child birth. Yes.
Agreed? Parturition, process of childbirth. One is lactation. Do you know, people know these words? It is the breastfeeding of child. Getting my point? Lactation. It is the breastfeeding of child. That is lactation. Yes or no? Do you people know all these terms? I will be talking about human reproductive system. Human reproductive system. Here, if you will see, one is male reproductive system. Another is female reproductive system. Can I say human male and female looks different? Means human shows sexual dimorphism. I will see or say over here. Human is a sexually reproducing and viviparous organism. What is the meaning of viviparous? Giving birth to child, not laying down egg. Otherwise, it would have been oviparous. Viviparous is giving birth to child or young one directly. So I will be discussing with male reproductive system. I will be discussing with male reproductive system. Agreed, everyone? Hariharan, what are you saying? Please ask me, dear. Hariharan, any question is there, dear? Okay, no issues. Let's see. It consists of first, testes. This is the plural form. Testis is the singular form. Testes. It is the primary sex organ. What? Because it produces gametes. Agreed to my point. It produces gametes. That is why it is the primary sex organ of male. Then second is accessory ducts. And third is accessory gland. Can you people see over here? This reti testis part, epididymis part, vas deferens and all. Can you see? They are accessory ducts. For that, I have taken one more diagram over here.
Reti testis. This one, efferent duct. Okay. Vas efferens. Then this is coiled part is epididymis. This one is vas deferens, which is going through this and coming to urethra and coming out through this. Yes or no? What all accessory glands are there? Seminal vesicle, prostate gland, and bulbo urethral gland. Yes or no? What all are the accessory gland of human male? Seminal vesicle, prostate gland, and bulbo urethral gland. Yes or no, everyone? Everyone. Accessory duct having reti testis. Vasa efferentia, epididymis, vas deferens, urethra and all. Let's see. Accessory gland is seminal vesicle, prostate, and bulbo urethral gland. Agreed, everyone? No doubts in that? Now, testis having, can you see this pipe? Tell me, dear. What are they? They are seminiferous tubule. Agreed? They are seminiferous tubule and they are like this. They are like this. Have you discussed this diagram before? Have we discussed this diagram before, that germinal epithelium and all, while discussing testis in endocrine system? See, this is seminiferous tubule. Inside it are cuboidal epithelium like this. It is going to be lined by cuboidal epithelium and few cells are there which will be tall columnar like this. Let's see. These kind of structures are there all over in this cell also. I am not making now. This is known as germinal epithelium. From here only sperm are going to be formed. Now, what is that? This is Sertoli cells. Everyone agreed to this point? They are Sertoli cells. So if somebody will ask you, seminiferous tubule is lined by germinal epithelium, Sertoli cells, or both?
both, everyone. So this is there. Now, can you see this space outside the cell, outside the seminiferous tubule? Can you see that? I'm going to discuss Aditya now only. Here, these cells are known as interstitial cells, because they are present inside the interstitial space. Agreed, everyone? Tell me, dear. Interstitial cells or leading cells. What is its location? What is its location? Tell me, dear. Its location is outside the seminiferous tubule, between the seminiferous tubules. Yes or no? Sertoli cells are going to provide nourishment to developing sperm, and interstitial, they are going to secrete testosterone.
Bolo.
Everyone, tell me, dear. Are you done with this? Are you done with this? Testosterone. If you will talk about just few minutes only, this is female reproductive system. It consists of ovary. This is the primary sex organ, for the same reason, because it is going to provide the gamete, the ovum. Getting my point? Ovum will be released over here and will be taken by infundibulum of fallopian tube. Ampulla is there, isthmus is there. Now, what is ampulla? It is the site of fertilization. Ampulla is site of fertilization. Here, fertilization is going to take place. Agreed, dear? Here, fertilization is going to take place. That is ampulla. Through isthmus, now here, fertilization will take place. Zygote will be formed. And this will move through this. It is coming. It will come over here and it will be implanted over here. Development will take place. Let's see what will happen after that. A placenta will be formed. This is umbilical cord, and here the fetus is going to be there. Yes or no? So this is known as uterus. Uterus having three lining. You can say in the wall, three tissues are there. One is endometrium, one is myometrium, and one is perimetrium. Myometrium is made up of a smooth muscle. It contracts during parturition and lead to childbirth. Yes or no? So which layer is responsible for childbirth? If that will be asked, what is your answer? It is myometrium, no? See, this area of uterus is known as cervix. its canal is known as cervical canal. This is vagina. This is known as vaginal canal. Cervical canal and vaginal canal will form birth canal. Everyone, do you have any doubt in this? Tell me, dear. Tell me. Few things are there. You people can read from your NCERT. We'll meet you all in the next class. And if you have any doubt, do not hesitate to ask. Yes or no? Bye, everyone.